In today's video, I am speaking to the new and young mom who has just transitioned to a new environment. You would agree with me that life in a new environment can be exciting, can be overwhelming, can be stressful. I mean, your emotions are valid. You are just trying to adjust to this new environment. You are learning and relearning some habits. You are connecting with new people. Experiences are bound to happen. I have been there. I can relate. I know how it feels. In this video, I'm going to share with you 5 tips that I have been learning to adjust myself in a new environment. First thing is to find a community of people who speak your language, who talk your talk, who believe in what you believe in. I mean, like-minded people. It can be from a mommy support group, it can be from church, it can be from work, from school, whatever that community feels like to you, make sure you have one of them. Personally, I like to find these people at church simply because I want to be connected to the source, I want to grow my faith, and I feel like the church is one place that can serve many purposes for the whole family. That can connect with the men's ministry. Mom can connect with the women, the teenagers, if you have one, can find the youth ministry, the kids can find the Sunday school ministry. So personally, I feel like the church is a perfect place for me. Second tip for you will be to know your surroundings. As moms, we are often the movers and the shakers in the home, right? And so you want to know the local resources around you. Where is the playground? Where is the library? Where is the pediatrician's office? You know, some of those basic things that can really make your life easy, less stressful, that can help you not to worry about a lot of things that you still need to get done. And remember in point one, I told you, find a community. I like to check with them. Hey, so where do you all hang out with the kids? What are some of the things that you do around here? What are some of the pediatricians you have used? What was your experience with them? These tips really come in handy, especially if you are someone like me who likes to, you know, get real experience from people and not just reading stuff online from strangers. I think this will really come in handy. Third tip for you will be to build new habits and routine. This is very important, especially if you are moving from one culture to another culture. Depending on where you are coming from, this can be like a whole new shift, and you have to learn new routines. You have to learn how to do things a little different than what you knew. If you are moving from a very communal culture and now you are moving into this individualistic culture where everybody tends to mind their business, you go out there, it's just you, you come in, it's just you. You really want to build new routines. Like, things just happen so fast. Nobody has time for anybody. Nobody has time for anything. So you really want to build new routines. If you are a working mom, or even if you're a stay-at-home mom, you want to build new routines. Like, maybe at first you used to cook every single day. In case in this new space, there is no time, life is happening so fast, and so you really want to start learning how to like cook your food bulky, have them in the fridge and warm them bit by bit so that you can have some time to relax. You can have some time for your partner or for your baby as well. So in this phase, you will be learning and unlearning some new things. Maybe at first you didn't used to exercise, but in this your new environments, depending on the kind of culture and lifestyle there, you might want to get into the habit of exercising every now and then, maybe going out for a walk, maybe taking a little sunshine, you know? So you have to be ready and prep for new habits and routines. My fourth tip for you will be to make some time to connect with yourself. When you are a mom, it is easy for you to fill everybody's cup and forget to fill your own cup. You're taking care of daddy, you're taking care of the kids, you're taking care of every other business that is going on around you. And sometimes it is easy for you to forget yourself. I have had some friends tell me, like, Lydia, I didn't know who I was in the early years of parenting. Like, I just couldn't find myself again. Don't let this happen to you. Make some time to just connect with yourself. Whatever time of connection means to you, if reading your Bible, meditating, praying is something that really gets you energized, if exercising, connecting with your loved ones is something that really gets you excited, that fills your cup, that makes your face light up, like, you know, find some time to do this for you. Sometimes it might mean waking up an hour or two earlier than the whole family, just to do your own thing, exercise, you know, read your Bible, journal, meditate on the scriptures, whatever that means for you. Find some time to do it. And this is really important because you cannot give from an empty cup. You can give what you don't have, right? So it's important to take some time and really make time for you, connect with your soul, connect with yourself. And that takes me to my next and final tip for you, and this will be try new things. Life in a new environment can be exciting, can also be overwhelming. You know, it comes with a lot of mixture of emotions. You are getting to know new people, you are learning about culture, you are learning how to do things a little differently than what you were used to and what you know. So just be open-minded and be willing to try new things. I think this is really going to be helpful. And don't be afraid to ask. Sometimes there might be some things, some practices that may come new to you. Just ask the people you find around you, your community, your support system. If you feel like, oh, this is a question that might come out across like, maybe I'm dumb and I don't want to ask, let me give you a trick. These days, thank God for AI, the internet. Go on there, ChatGPT, Google Gemini, whichever you prefer, and ask your question. Sometimes you can even ask how to ask this or how to ask that. So before you go and meet the person, you kind of have a fair idea how to go around it, what are some of the questions to ask and not to ask. So make good use of that. And this is a bonus tip. Keep in touch. Whilst you are navigating life in a new environment, don't forget your family and friends in your old environments. Make some time to call, to connect. Hey, I'm just checking up on you. How is everybody? How is life? You know, those little talks can really come in handy. Plus, it really helps you to nurture those relationships. Don't wait till after 5, 6, 7 years you need something and you're not trying to connect with somebody in your old environment. Really. You call people only when you need them or when you need help from them. No, it shouldn't be so. So try to keep in touch. Just water those relationships and keep them going. This is something I am also really trying hard to work on. So I hope that we do it together and we get better. If you found this tip helpful, this is Ed Intentional. Please subscribe to my channel. Share with a friend who might need this information. And if you are looking for a mommy community, welcome. We love to have you here. We are just getting started with this party and we have more in stock. So please come join us. Thank you for watching and be blessed.